Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, I'm Anna and I'm a little bit spooky, and today we are creating this cool tone, kind of neutral, smoky eye, a nice going out evening look using the e.l.f. Bite Size palette in Truffle. I kind of love the way this came out, and it looks almost dead on to a look that I would do with the Huda Smoky Obsession, so I'm really pleased with that, and I decided to pair it with a warm blush, warm red lip, and most other products on my face are from e.l.f. If not e.l.f., they are drugstore. So yeah, if you want to see how I got this look and hang out with me for a little bit, go ahead and keep on watching. But before you do, don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment down below. Let me know some products you would like to see me play with, some looks you would like to see. Let me know in the comments down below. And without further ado, let's get into this look. Brows are on, eyes are primed. We have some chai tea. It's very hot, you can't drink it yet. Okay, so today I want to use the e.l.f. Little Bite Size Eyeshadow Palette in Truffle, because I think it's something about the simplicity of this palette I really like. It's just, it's pretty. It's kind of a nice staple palette, and I'm going to create a little look with it. We're also going to use e.l.f. blush later on in Always Spicy, as well as all e.l.f. brushes to create this look, because I don't know, I'm a fan of e.l.f. I also used the Instant Lift Brow Pencil in my brows today. We're just having an e.l.f. day. Totally unintentionally, it just kind of happened. So yeah, let's go ahead and just get started. So yeah, I have prime eyes, set them down with some translucent powder, brows are done, you know, my usual routine. So I'm gonna start this look off with a e.l.f. fluffy blending brush. I don't know what these are called. Yeah, eye blender brush, and we're gonna go right into this shade right here, which is the kind of a, as that girl Shay would say, a puppy brown. It's kind of a camel neutral type of shade. I see what she means when she calls a shade a puppy brown. This is a puppy brown. And I'm just gonna pick a little bit of that up. I haven't used this palette yet, really. I kind of slapped on a look with it the other night, but I didn't really pay attention to what it did. So yeah, first impression-ish. So I'm gonna start running this through the transition socket. I'm gonna start with a light hand, just to see how it goes, because I'm not sure how pigmented these are or whatnot. I think I'm gonna go for like a smoky eyeliner look. Either way, we're going smoky, because, I mean, this palette is very much geared towards that. One thing that really drew me to this palette is it's almost like a little bit of a replacement for the Huda Smoky Obsessions. A little more pared down, even though that one's quite small, you know, in selection. I just, the black in it broke on me, so I'm like, yeah, that's like, I don't know, for a go-to smoky palette, I need a black eyeshadow. I'm on the hunt for a replacement. I think I'm gonna pick up the LA Girl one, in fact. I'm just gonna build this shade up in the transition socket area. So far, it's not overly pigmented, it's just right. It's building easily. Like, I really tapped my brush off that first time just to make sure it wasn't gonna be too much. And yeah, so far, so good. Look at that, that's nice. Very smooth blend, effortless blend, in fact. Gonna further build that up some more. I'm basically gonna be doing my go-to, like, going out kind of glam look that doesn't involve gold for once. This is more if I want to go for a neutral color scheme, or like if I wanted to wear like silver jewelry or something. Yeah, this is building really nicely. Now I think on a e.l.f. blending brush, which is kind of a flat and fluffy brush at the same time. One of my favorite types of brushes because they're very functional and multi-use. I'm gonna go in with the next shade over, which is the more deeper chocolatey brown, and we're gonna put that in the outer V and into the socket as well. This brown comes off quite a bit more cool tone on the eye than it appears in the palette. I mean, it's pretty neutral cool in the palette, but I'm just gonna let that blend into the lighter brown. I'm gonna kind of pull that out on the outer corner and create that nice lift and just soften those edges. Ooh, that's really nice. That looks really good. Good job, e.l.f. so far. Like, the pigmentation is just right. Like, it's not overly pigmented that you can't control it, but it's pigmented enough that you don't have to work and feel like it's just blending away. Like, this is definitely high-end quality. The hype is real. I'm like, I mean, this is basically interchangeable for the Huda palette, in my opinion, as far as quality and blend goes. And I'm gonna blend that out with the big blending brush again and a little bit of the lighter brown. Just a little bit of kick up in the pan, not much. This isn't a necessary step. I'm just being a little extra blendy because you know how I like to blend and kind of sit here and paint a little bit when I sit down to do my eyeshadow. Like, I feel like I didn't do enough if I don't go back and blend some more. Just go around these edges, soften that out, get that nice gradient. So I'm gonna jump back to a smaller brush. I wanna see how the black eyeshadow reforms real quick. I'm gonna take a little bit of it on the tip of the brush and on the outer V, very outer corner here, kind of wiggle it in. Yep, that's a good black. Very nice, very easy to work with. Not too much, but just right. They've nailed a just right formula here, in my opinion. I just wanna try it real quick because I am gonna go with eyeliner first and then smoke that eyeliner out with the black. I just wanna see what the black did on its own. Can I just pull that a little bit over into the socket just a bit? Just to get that lift on the outer corner. If I'm not mistaken, there is like little bits of sparkle in the black, like so micro, tiny sparkles that I don't know if they just accidentally got in there from this shade or if they're just in the formula, but they're like virtually invisible. Just, they're in there. Just build that up a little just because I can. And I'm switching the way I hold the brush, depending what area I'm working on. Like if I'm going through the crease like this, I've got the brush kind of flat like that. And then when I kind of want to blend, I turn it to where it's vertical. All right, so let's do a little bit of gel liner real quick. I'm just gonna start the outer part of the lashes. And I'm not worried about being real neat or anything because we are gonna kind of make it smoky and blend it. So I'm gonna start here at the outer corner. I like to keep my eye relaxed when I do my liner. That way I can make sure it's not getting weird with the hoodedness of my eyes and all that. I just relax them and pretend like the fold isn't there and just go across it. This side's a little bit trickier for me because it's a little more hooded. If I'm going for a precision, this isn't my favorite brush. It's not worried about being super precise, just more about getting the shape mapped out because we're gonna be doing the smokiness with the shadow. You could do this without the liner. I just think it adds a nice base to get that deep dark intensity out there. Those wings are totally different. I usually start on this side and do the other one. And I'm going to pull it across just a halfway for right now. I'll come back and touch it up towards the end of the look. It's just mapping a shape out at this point. You can always clean up with a little bit with your Q-tip just a bit. Tidy up some. It's good enough for right now since we're going to go ahead and do the eyeshadow next. The smokiness. So I'm going to clean that little angled brush off that I used to apply it. I'm going to get all the eyeliner off of it. And then go into the black shadow and then just tap it over it to start. And I usually get fallout when I do this. And I'm supposed to kind of smudge it in. Just with a little flicking motion like this, coming inward. And just kind of smudges it over some. This is a really good technique for hooded eyes because it hides the excess skin that might be hanging down over your mobile lid, if that makes sense. Sometimes that little bit that's hanging down, like right here, this little fold will make a kink in the eyeshadow and it look really weird, or it looks like it's uneven. But just make it a little smokier, a little bit of black eyeshadow with it, and you don't have that problem. And you still get the effect of a winged liner look. You still get the lift of it. And of course, the older I've gotten, I've had to change the way I do liner over the years just because my eyes have gotten a little bit more hooded every year. It's just a thing for getting older. Then we're gonna go ahead and take that little blending brush from before and dip a little bit of black. Dip it in the black just a little bit and I'll wiggle it right out here. A smaller brush would work a little bit better for this part, but it gets it done. You just have to be a little bit more precise. A little bit more careful. There. That's a nice little blend on there. Alright. The quality of the eyeshadow really does make a difference when you're doing something like this because you really want it to be able to blend smoothly and kind of flow into the skin and into the other shadows without it getting skippy or weird. And this palette is doing the job perfectly. I'm gonna take a little bit of the brown now. I like to kind of create a little bit of a gradient. Back to the blending brush and the lightest brown. And just make sure everything is looking smooth and blended. So now I'm going to take this little Wet n Wild brush, because I don't have a flat brush from e.l.f. We're going to go into that taupey shimmer right here. This is such a pretty, like, really taupey silvery. Like, it has a silvery shift in there, but it's a taupe. Very cool tone taupe. I'm going to put this on the inner part of the eyelid. That's very pretty. That's a nice shimmer. It's a very nice shade. And there's a shade almost just like this in the Huda palette. And that's one of the things I liked about it so much. I'm really focusing it just on the inner part here. I'm just going right up to the socket. Cool. I'm going to take this brush again. The little flat fluffy e.l.f. eyeshadow brush. Take a little bit of the brown. The darker brown. And just go between the shimmer and the black. Just really lightly. Just do a smooth little gradient right there. That's where it joins up to the wing and everything, and it's just all flowing. Take a little bit more gel liner and just kind of tight line a little bit right in here. Just really get between those lashes. And you know, I didn't get a whole lot of fallout. I'm pretty impressed. e.l.f. has got some great products. And I think, yeah, they get some hype, but I still feel like they're always kind of looked down on a little bit. Like, they're never, I don't know, everybody's like, oh my god, I can't believe this is e.l.f. I think at this point, they've established themselves to where they're like, yeah, e.l.f.'s a good brand. You know who brands that let me down with eyeshadows are brands like Maybelline, L'Oreal. I'm gonna clean up what little bit of fallout I've got, which is hardly any, which is quite impressive. And I'm gonna go do my face makeup. I'll be back to finish up the lower lash line, blush, highlight, and lip. So move on to that lower lash line before my brain explodes. I'm gonna take that lightest brown now on one side of this brush, and I'm gonna start to run that along here. I'm gonna keep this part not too much eyeshadow there. Now let's take the darkest brown, same way, load it up on one side of the brush. Focus it even further out. Oops, oops, oops. Big oops. Okay. I knew that was gonna happen. We're gonna get way too. Can we fix this? Yes, we can. Beauty blender. Yeah, we can fix it. Okay, that's fine. That's fine. I'm gonna switch to another brush. Fuck trying to use one brush. Where's my trusty lower lash line brush? I'm gonna take this little Morphe 124. We're gonna go into the darkest brown. Try that again. I'm gonna get the lightest brown. Blend that out just a little bit. We got a little crazy. Thank goodness for a few blender slums and product on. Alright, let's take a little bit of the black. Just right here to join it into the wing. Okay, we are making progress. Now I'm gonna clean off that little e.l.f. brush that screwed us up really well, and then kind of smoke it out some. All right, now towards the inner corner here, I'm gonna take that shimmer shade and just put it right there, right into the inner corner. Yeah, that's quite a nice little look, despite our little goof there. This is definitely a look I like to go to with the Huda Smoky Obsessions right here. This is like the exact look I would create with it. And now I can do it for $3, I think $3 or $4, and have one without a black eyeshadow missing. Mostly all I use it for now is the brown in it to fill in my brows. That was one perk of it. It had that lighter brown in it that worked my brows, and I don't think these shades necessarily will do that. I don't know. You know, this darkest shade might actually work in my eyebrows. Let's just try a little bit of it and see. Yeah, I think I could fill my brows in with that. Because it looks much warmer in the pan than it is in application. That'll do. It's a little warm, but looks fine to me. Let's move on to the rest of the face. Now, I also used the e.l.f. Camo Concealer today. Like four other e.l.f. brushes. The e.l.f. Brow Pencil. I feel like I used something else. I can't remember what it is. Anyway, let's move on to highlight real quick, which is gonna be from e.l.f. We're gonna use the White Gold highlighter, which is one of my favorites, just in general. We hit the high points. Anywhere that the light would naturally catch on my face, I'm looking pretty matte. And let's go on with blush. I'm going to use Always Spicy, which the shade is awfully pigmented, but we're gonna make it work. I'm going to go in with a very light hand. One little dab in. Dab off some of the excess. And I love the tone of this one, though. That's such a pretty blush. And I want to bring some warmth in, because I know the eyes are kind of cold. I think pairing it with this really warm, dark terracotta colored blush, and we're going to do a nice red, rusty red lip with it instead of a cool tone lip, would look really nice. A lot of times I would put like a berry lip with this, and I think that can also look beautiful. But I'm just in the mood to do something a little warm on the rest of the face. Kind of a contrast. I'm going to do some mascara really quick. My Lash Princess from Essence, my favorite. I don't feel like doing falsies today. Okay, let's move on to lips. Now, I do not have anything from e.l.f. for lips. Yeah, well, I have like one thing, but it's the wrong color. So I'm going to use Charlotte Tilbury Legendary Queen lip liner. Or no, Walk of Shame lip liner. Just to get really light. It's just any red lip liner. Like burnt red. This is not actually the tone I'm going to need. I think, didn't she change this to like Walk of No Shame, or is that a new shade? It's kind of Walk of Shame is a little cringy, isn't it? Lips, I'm going to take one of the L'Oreal Paris matte lip crayons in the shade Flirty Toffee. You know this is one of my favorites, especially for this time of year. It's like just perfect. Like Mac Auburn would have been better lip liner for this. I'm going to go get dressed and fix my hair, put my jewelry on, and be back for the finished look. All right, and we are finished. Finished look. I just decided to pair this look with a band tee and a blazer, because this final thoughts on that little e.l.f. bite-sized palette. It is absolutely awesome and worth more than the $3 or $4 I paid for it, that's for sure. It's pretty fantastic. And yeah, most of our face was e.l.f. and drugstore, so that is pretty cool. I will see you guys in the next one. Thanks for hanging out and watch me play with some eyeshadow. Yeah, I'll see y'all later. Stay spooky and stay safe. Bye now.